Ayat Muhammad Aqil Afriz bin Muhammad about power management system of solar smart house. First, there are two situations which that when there is the presence of sunlight and when there is no sunlight. We have managed to design the system just now into the MATLAB coding. Okay, but this is just a trial. We are not the system is not being interfaced by the circuit yet. Okay, let me show how this system works in the MATLAB. Okay, let's say when there is when the solar panel sends the light, it will give some reading to the system. Let me say it's 1, and the system we assume now the battery is 0. So like I mentioned before, the battery will charge and that will charge the battery, and at the same time will give the power supply to the house. Okay, let's say the usage now is 2500 watt. Okay, the appliance had reached 50% of the power consumption, which is the limit is 5000. So 50% is 2500 watt. So it will beep once as the reminder to the user. And now the battery is being charged into 5000 watt. Okay, let's say it's now the power consumption now is 3000 and it still beep once because it not reached 75%, but the battery is keep charging into 10,000 watt. Okay, now let's say it's 4000, the power consumption is 4000, and the buzzer had beep twice as the reminder to user it have reached 75% and the battery is now at 15,000 watt. And as the appliance reach 5000, the appliance are not allowed because it reached the limit and the user need to switch off any other appliance to use that appliance. Okay, now the battery is now fully charged, and let me show how when there is when there is no sunlight. Okay, when there is no sunlight, it will give nothing value to the system, and it will use the battery. As the battery being used, battery have the mode which is safe mode. Okay, safe mode is 25% of the power of the battery power. The battery power, I assume the maximum is 20,000 watt, and if the usage is not reached 25%, it's not activate the safe mode. Okay, so when the usage of the battery had for the whole day had reached remaining 25%, it will activate the safe mode. Like let me say 18,000. Okay, now the battery safe mode is activated to save the usage of the battery in the house. Okay, that's all for me. Thank you.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Umi Suhaila binti Sulaiman. I will explain about current progress on power scheduling. As we can see, we use Arduino software. We put the instruction A, C, E, G, I, and we get the appliances for refrigerator, microwave, heater and television and laptop are on. And we put B, D, F, H and J for application refrigerator, microwave, heater, television and laptop off. As we can see, the system automatic shown the total power use and available power. While when we put some the instruction that exceed the maximum power usage, the warning will be executed and displayed on the screen.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Muhammad Syahrul Hamdi bin Mustafa. I will explain about comfort condition lighting.
Okay, this is the Arduino sketch. Hashtag include liquid crystal hash. This is the library code for LCD LCD display, and then this is the number of digital pin connected to LCD display, and then the delay factor we use float type because it is in decimal, and then for this is the input pin for LDR, we use 8 input pin for LDR, and then this is the variable to store the value coming from the sensor. We use float type also, and then void setup. This is to set the output for LED light. We use 22 to 37 digital pin, and then serial begin, LCD begin, void loop. This is to read the value of all LDR. The sensor value 0 to 5, 0 to 7. This is the formula for the light factor, and then this is to print to LCD display DF1, DF2, DF3, DF4, and this is the condition for first room. If the light factor is less than 4, first LED 22 will light up, and this condition will rotate, will be repeat for all LED light. And last one, serial print in, is to print the LDR value in serial monitor. Okay, this is the circle. There are 8 LDR, and this is the LED, only 3 LCD I set up, and this is the LDR reading on LCD display, DF1 for room 1, room 2, room 3 and room 4. Okay, right now I only managed to display the daylight factor, and after this I will try to run up the LED light. Okay, that's all from me. Thank you.
Assalamualaikum. My name is Nur Izzati binti Jamaluddin, and I will explain to you the comfort control air quality monitoring system for midterm design review. So I have included two proposed methodology, which are hardware and software. So we go first to hardware. This is the diagram of the circuit that has been assembled. So you can see the Wi-Fi module, MQ135, Arduino, and the LCD. So for the software, this is the coding for the project. So this is, as you can see, this is the library for MQ135, and I use software serial to make the pin 9 of Arduino as the RX and pin 10 as the TX. So I also include liquid crystal library to display the result in the LCD. But before that, we have to calibrate the MQ135. So I have uploaded this coding and have run it for 12 to 24 hours. So for the future works, I plan to make the connection of fans to the circuit and add coding respectively. Second, I will test the device in very dusty and poor air ventilation to see how buzzer works. And the third one is design prototype suitable for display while keeping the circuit functioning. So that's all from me.